See, NRHM is a program that is funded by Government of India, but it works along with the state health machinery. And along with the state health funding, the NRHM program aims at achieving the goals of the mission and also the Millennium Development Goals. So we are working in all the areas of health sector, and especially the mother and child health, including the national programs also.
Yes, ma'am. What is the role of ICT to achieve the goals of NRHM in India?
No, I think don't confine your discussion. Sorry. Don't keep it to NRHM, because I'm maybe MD NRHM, but then also I'm Secretary Health. So that way, you know, you have to structure it in the health sector side.
How I see.
How do you see that ICT has changed the health scenario in Gujarat?
See, ICT in general has helped in the public service delivery. Healthcare sector has a very large component as far as public service delivery is concerned. In increasing the efficiency of services, in increasing the effectiveness of the services, and also in increasing the reach of the services, ICT can play a large role in public service delivery. So similarly, we find that ICT has a very large role to play in the health sector as well. Be it simply the data for the health services, where we just take the data, analyze it, and use it for future purposes. Be it something like IDSP, where we are using ICT for disease surveillance and also trying to forecast epidemics. Be it a hospital management information system, where we are recording the individual details of each and every patient that comes into the hospital and then also retrieving it later when it is needed. Or be it mother and child tracking, eMamta, where we are taking the family health database of each and every family and tracking the mother and children of each and every family, of the pregnant mothers, of the children in the age where they require immunization or where they require nutrition and growth services. So all that finds a lot of use in the healthcare sector, especially in reaching out to the people most effectively, and also in trying to find out whether we have reached them or not, in trying to find out the left outs of the service, and in trying to also reach them more effectively, in the sense that we can use mobile technology for reaching out to them in the form of alerts. So I think that in general, ICT has a lot of use for health sector in general.
Yeah, great. Now, what should be the roadmap to achieve the goals of health access to all?
See, health access to all, as far as IT roadmap is concerned, we have to see it in terms of various levels of service delivery. We have the primary care level of service delivery, we have the secondary care level, and we have the tertiary care level. The issue is that all the three levels are different. Where at the level of the primary care, the issues are more in terms of knowing the nature of demand the public health has, knowing the service delivery to the individual patient in terms of the public health delivery, in terms of national programs, in terms of basic MCH services. At the secondary and the tertiary level, it comes mainly in the form of maintaining detailed patient information, which can be used for better patient management, and which can be used further for even teaching, for documentation, for cross-learning. So all these things are very relevant. A roadmap in the health sector would basically, I think, involve reaching out to everyone, especially in the remote areas, either through telemedicine network, which can be through the use of the mobile technology also, which can be through the use of the connectivity, internet connectivity, or any other connectivity model. But basically, we would be reaching out to the remote areas, making them services available at the doorstep through the use of technology, and also better patient management through the use of technology.
Ma'am, according to you, what kind of re-engineering is needed for effective implementation of ICT in
healthcare? See, like any other sector, what we require in the health sector also is the data integration. Because what is happening is that a patient's health data is recorded in different forms at different places in different databases, be it with the government or with the private. What is required is that bringing all that data together, converge it into something like of an integrated data where you get one point information on any person. So that's a big challenge and it requires a lot of convergence. So and the convergence part is very challenging, very difficult, but certainly I think we will be able to achieve it one day.
Ma'am, please elaborate on the challenges faced while deploying new technology in healthcare.
The most important challenge is reaching out. The reach is the most important challenge. See, we have connectivity up till the PHC level and PHCs are located in the villages. But not all states have connectivity up till that level. There are various kind of issues, hardware issues, electricity issues, connectivity issues. We are able to reach out up till the village level through eGram also. So, as far as ICT is concerned in the health sector, the most important challenge is reach. How to reach to the grassroots? If you are able to reach to your ultimate beneficiary at the doorstep, you have addressed one big challenge. The second big issue is of data quality. If the data quality is not there, and if you are not having a good kind of data without any errors, mistakes, duplications, then only you are able to get results that reflect the reality. Otherwise, your analysis will throw some details which may perhaps not reflect the actual reality. So data quality is again a very big challenge. And third issue, as I told you, is again of data convergence, bringing the entire data into one big umbrella where the it can be used more effectively for public service delivery.
What are your views on the inclusion?
Mobile technology has got lot of scope in the healthcare sector. The first thing that we are using in our eMamta child and mother tracking system is we are using SMS alerts. That is, when the service is due to you, you should be able to get an SMS alert that this service is due now. For example, a vaccine is due. So you should be able to know that a vaccine is due this week, so I should go to the public delivery center, public health center, and get that vaccination done. Because what we see is that, after all, every people may be quite meticulous, but even then, in the health sector, demand is a big issue, and the socially optimal demand level can be reached with the help of mobile technology. Mobile technology can also help in information, education and communication, which is a very important component in the healthcare programs. Because in the health sector, a lot of patient or client counseling is required on what is good for the patient, what is good for the client in terms of the health issues. So all that can be addressed through the mobile technology. Another issue is of reach. The reach which cannot be obtained otherwise through other methods. Since now the mobile reach is increasing, with the mobile reach we can increase the reach through the use of mobile, and we can also input the data using the mobile technology, and we can get the data using the mobile technology. These are some of the areas with which we are working. Perhaps there may be some other ones also. And I'm very sure, because now we see that even if the person is not having other gadgets, they prefer to carry a mobile. And we find that, considering the utility of mobile in the day-to-day life and also in the income generation process, people are carrying mobile very normally, very, very commonly. So it's a very good way of reaching to the people, reaching to the beneficiaries, reaching to the clients, and in return, making the healthcare services reach to them. So everything boils down to basically reaching to the clients.
My last question is, ma'am, what is the mantra of success of all the development scheme in Gujarat? And all the states should follow it.
I think good leadership, sustained effort, professional way of handling things, and a will to develop, a positive attitude towards development. I think these are always the basic things that are required in achieving success in any field.